fell to the invaders. For many years, our rulers did little to turn fortune to our favor. Some fought against their brethren, seeking petty advantages and even joining with the enemy. But others were steadfast. God sent us three worthy leaders whose boldness restored courage and hope to the faithful. First came Zangi, who, with the fury of wildfire, seized the city of Edessa. Next came Zangi's son, Nur ed-Din, who called for unity among the Muslim forces, and all hearts were attached to his cause. Boldest of them all was Nur ed-Din's student, Salah ed-Din Yusuf, whom the Franks called Saladin. As a young man, Saladin showed great promise. Blessed with a mind sharp and bright as a Damascene blade, he would one day prove himself a skilled tactician. But like all on the path to greatness, he would first be tested in the forge fire of war. The Franks had staked their claim on Egypt, intruding again and again with unquenchable greed. Meanwhile, Egypt's Fatimid rulers fought one another for power, their struggles spilling over into Nur ed-Din's realm. And so, into Egypt marched the army of Damascus, with Asad ed-Din Shirkuh at its head, charged with settling the festering turmoil and expelling the Franks. Salah ed-Din Yusuf, called Saladin by the Franks, was at this time a young man, unproven in battle, but cunning as a spider. Asad ed-Din Shirkuh, the Lion of the Mountain, a military man of Kurdish origin, served at Nur ed-Din's behest. For each territory captured, Shirkuh would gain the support of the local Fatimid garrison. Fatimid Egypt churned with political unrest. Some made pacts with foes of any banner, only to change their allegiance when fortunes shifted. With the wind at their backs, reinforcements arrived at the port with a fresh zeal for the fight.
حضرت الأوامر اصطفوا اركبوا أيها الخيالة الآن إلى تأدية الوقت أحدهم يطلق علينا أشدوا أمرك سيدي تحركوا انت تحركوا ايها الجنود الى الامام الان اعدوا انفس جاهزوا
with the warmth of dawn upon them the Damascene seized the upper hand in the battle for control Cherkov knew that the Franks would not stand idle as their losses mounted. He would rally his men to defend the newly gained territories.
يا قوم حضرت الأوام نحن نهجم الخيال اركبوا أيها الخيال
Joining their Frankish brethren, a new foe emerged onto the field. The Knights Templar.
استعدوا أيها الجنود
أنا سأفعل
مصطفوا
أعدوا أنفسك اتبعوا الأوامر
الخيالة أيها الخيالة شدوا على المهاميز جاهزوا أيها الخيالة تحركوا الآن إلى وقت المسير سأفعل
أنا سأفعل يا سيدي
الخيالة يلا
الآن هيا أسرعوا.
أنصت هيا بنا
أمر يا سيد.
سيروا إلى الأمام ثورتكم
اثبتوا الآن
أعدوا أنفسكم
الخير
أسمعوا
حالا
Seeking the advantage, each side stoked the fires of war as ever more soldiers rallied to the front.
استعدوا أيها
نعم بالطبع
مصطفى أفعل
يا قوم حضر أمرك
تغيير التشكيل
يا قوم حضرة الأول
انتبهوا
جاهزون الآن إلى تادية سأفعل
اصطفوا
سأفعل
أيها الخيالة تحركوا
اثبتوا
Reduced in number and spirit, the Franks of Jerusalem broke their camp and began their joyless march out of Egypt. Shirkuh soon claimed Cairo for Nur ed-Din, but Egypt's governance would not long after fall to his illustrious nephew, Saladin.